try to live your life right. People really know you push your buttons like type right. This is like a movie, but it's really very lifelike. Every single night. Hi Gumi and Morki, thank you so much for having me on Open Play. I really am humbled, and yeah, it's a privilege to be on your show, and I really love what you guys are doing with it and the messages that you want to get across to the rest of our rugby community. So I am a graduate of the College of Cape Town, but for my 2 years there, they didn't have a rugby team. So in my first year, I played my rugby for Durbel Rugby Club. And in my second year, I played my rugby for Hamilton's Rugby Club. So I just made sure that I prioritized my schoolwork and my rugby. So obviously during the week, it's class and practice, but I had time on Friday and I made sure that I covered a certain amount of work before the game on Saturday. If I didn't, then I'll just tell the coach that I'm not. So I knew that there are a lot of players who are younger and upcoming, you know, that are younger, faster, stronger and smarter at the game, and they all wanted the same opportunities that I had, hence that really motivated me to complete my studies in the event that I won't be able to play anymore. I would have something to fall back onto. Yeah, I definitely would have gone professional if I was given the opportunity. You know, you get to see a different part of the world, you experience different cultures, you experience different people, and what happens and that on all of that stuff happens outside of the four lines, and you know, it makes you a better person. You know, you'll be able to relate to people differently, and you know, you won't be as narrow-minded as you were going into the situation. So yeah, I would have gladly gone professional if I had the opportunity, but the problem with that is that the talent pool to pick from is very big and the window of opportunity is rough. Yeah, so it's unfortunate that, or rather fortunate that work pays the bills, and because of that, rugby has to come second. So I make sure that I finish whatever deadlines I have first, and then, you know, the rugby is, yeah, the rugby will just fall second to that.
Zombie with no conscience. Question, what are these things all have in common? Everybody knows I'm a motherfucking monster.
So I had well, still have 4 sporting heroes that I really enjoyed watching. So firstly, Quade Cooper and Aaron Cruden. Yeah, it was like they just had no regard for their game plan. You know, they always took risks, and they made the game of rugby very exciting with their flair and their skill level. The third person would be, just think now, is Israel Dagg. Yeah, he had a formidable goose step, and he was very good under the high ball, and yeah, he, you know, like one on one, he would beat anybody. And the last person is Aaron Smith. The thing that I love most about Aaron Smith is his attention to detail. I've never seen him throw a sloppy pass. I've never, you know, he's always talking. So yeah, it's, you know, he pays a lot of attention to, you know, to the small things that does it. So I think two things can be done in order to improve Namibia Sevens. And Kenya followed suit as well when Mike Friday was there. So firstly, it's play more games or play more tournaments. That way you get real-time feedback and you're able to improve there and then or at your next training session. And also get consultants to come in and help, because that way both your domestic... Yeah, so I just think it boils down to exposure. A lot of our coaches and management staff frown upon the idea of having their best players to represent the Volvichas in the Super Sport Challenge. When actually it's the opposite. You know, you get exposed to playing against your heroes or people that you look up to, and once you're within the four lines, it, you know, you realize, hey, you know, this guy's actually just as human as I am. He breathes, you know, he does bleed, and he does get sore when I tackle him. And I think that's the mental hurdle that we need to overcome. And it gives you a certain level of professionalism, so that when you come back to your club, it has a ripple effect on the next guy and the next guy and the, you know, and the people who are younger and under you. And they look up to you as, you know, as someone great. So even if you do get, you know, a smash in that weekend, you you can always go back to your club and be like, okay, hey, look, listen, I learned this, I learned that. And yeah. Obviously, I want to win the league with the Wanderers this year. The club is turning 100 years old, and it really is, it would be a special occasion to, you know, to win the league with them. But first and foremost, I really have to rehabilitate my knee first before I can even think about getting onto the field. My message would be for students is to remain disciplined in whatever respective discipline that they're in. You know, get the knowledge, get the necessary papers, because, you know, you're not going to be able to play rugby for very long. And at the end of the day, all that you're going to have is memories, and unfortunately, memories don't necessarily pay bills. So with that being said, you know, get your qualifications done and dusted, and then from there, once your rugby career is over, or if you feel that you're stagnating in your...